And I'm like, horrible. Like, what? I couldn't speak. And then he shows up like nothing happened. Like, literally, in a good mood, with a smile on his face. I don't understand. Hello guys, this is Irina, the Siberian who's gone international. And today it's gonna be a light topic just to discuss it with you. It's gonna be a conversational video and I hope you will leave your comments with your opinions about the topic. So I will talk about time, how other people understand it and how you understand it and how you think people should treat the time of other people, basically. I wanted to tell the story for a while. It has blown my mind when it happened, but it was like already a few years ago when I was in Tenerife. So we had a surf instructor there. He was nice. He was a cool, cheerful guy. We had good relationship. I mean, you know, as friends. I remember once he invited me to his friend's birthday and like I thought it were cool. And apparently we were. But one day he comes to our surfing camp, takes me to the surfing lesson. By the way, it was another camp. It wasn't the one that I made a review on. That one is cool. That other one was, I didn't like it. So that was the one that I didn't like. So yeah, coming back to the story. So the surfing instructor picks me up in the morning and drives me to the surfing lessons. We have it. And then I had an option, either to go back with him back to the surf camp or stay in this touristic area. And since I had two transfers included a day, I decided to stay in this touristic area because I knew that in the afternoon he's gonna take another group for a surfing and then I could go back together with them to the surfing camp. So he would give me a ride in the evening instead of giving me a ride during the day. And I told him like, okay, let's do it like that. In case something changes, just let me know and I'll, you know, find the way to the surf camp myself. And he's like, all right. I mean, the only thing which could have gone wrong is that he might not have had enough room in his car to take me. But, I mean, he could have told me that and I would have gone home by myself. Anyway, 9 o'clock comes and I hear nothing from him. And I'm like, how can I go home? Because we kind of, you know, agreed to meet at like a certain beach. But he's not responding and I'm like, maybe he's still in the water. So I'm like, okay, I'll wait. So I'm waiting and waiting and waiting. And thank God, like my friend was waiting with me. But he is not responding. And then eventually he wakes up and he's like, oh, sorry, we just got out of the water. I won't be able to take you home. There is nobody else going to the camp. And I'm like, okay, thank you for telling me this in advance. Because, you know, he knew that I'm waiting for him. We had this agreement that he's gonna either pick me up or let me know if he won't be able to pick me up. I was waiting for him for like one extra hour to just confirm that he's not coming. I think it was even a bit more complicated. There was even more confusion. But eventually I took this bus, which was like one of the last ones going to the surfing camp, and which took me like way longer. And then I arrived there and turns out that when he was texting to me on the beach, he was with other staff from our camp who had a car and who was going back to the camp, like from the exact place where I was to the exact place where I needed. And he like knew that there's a person who needs a ride that he promised to give. And somehow it never occurred to his mind that maybe he should let them know that they could pick me up. No. And I don't know, is it like my 40% Finnish blonde, which makes me like super punctual and responsible? Because I could never forget that there's somebody waiting for me to, you know, take them home, to meet them, to like give them something. I get super paranoid when I'm late myself. So when people act like this, it's just, I don't understand, like my mind literally blows because I don't understand. The next morning, he insisted on having the surf lesson early. So because of that, I had to take yoga like super early in the morning. So I had this yoga lesson, which I had included, scheduled for 7, which is insanely early for me. And it finished at like 7:55, and in 5 minutes that I had before his arrival, I like inhaled my breakfast and guess what? It's 8, it's 10 past 8, it's 20 past 8, it's 30 past 8, he's not there. And then he shows up at 8:40, like nothing happened. Like, literally, in a good mood, with a smile on his face, and he's like, hola, Irina, how you doing? And I'm like, horrible, like, what the, I couldn't speak, because, I mean, like, first, you forget me in the evening, on the beach, leaving me without a ride. I mean, I don't even think that he would have even written to me if I didn't contact him first. Then you appear 40 minutes late, even though it was you who suggested to have this lesson super early. And now you act like it's totally fine. I don't understand it. Honestly, I don't know if it's cultural. Do you think it's cultural? I mean, guys, if you are from the countries where time is like a relative thing, let me know, explain me. Because, I mean, I don't understand. I just don't. Because, you know, like, if you arrive later, like, there's a person waiting for you. They can't really do anything else but wait for you. So, it's like you're stealing this time, which is not, you know, refillable from their life. Why do you do that? I mean, planning your time is not that difficult. You just, you know, you just calculate how many minutes you need to do the trip to the point B from point A, and then you leave at this time, your point A. That's it. So yeah, like, I was really pissed. I didn't talk to him at all ever again. It was the last lesson, so I just spent it in a complete silence, surfing like a bit away from him, and that's it. And I think I'm right. Maybe this passive aggressive behavior is not the best thing to do to another person, but being 40 minutes late or forgetting somebody on the beach at night is even worse. So share your thoughts. Do you think that there are people who, I mean, I'm pretty sure, like, the funny thing is that I'm pretty sure that he didn't mean to, like, offend me. He didn't mean to do anything bad to me. It's just, like, in his head, it's, like, it works like that. Like, he doesn't see what is wrong with that. Like, I could feel that he really doesn't get, like, what's up. So, what do you think about this? Have you had that happen to you? I have another cool story about the similar subject. I mean, I have three actually, but maybe that's for another day. Thank you guys for watching. Thanks for listening to my rant. It's been a year and a half, but I still feel a bit angry. And I will see you in my next video. Bye!